Jello Biafra. Which would you rather have? A pint of booze if you're a recovering alcoholic, or a pint of cacophony, no matter what or who you are?
Speak into the mic, bitch.
Say that into the microphone.
Keep on rocking in the free world, and I mean rock, not pop punk. Not indie poo. Not middle of the road, Miley Cyrus-y dreck.
You're a freak with a microphone.
Oh, ladies and shitheads, welcome back to another episode of A Pint of Cacophony. My name is Dan. I don't know what episode this is. Fucking 6, 4, 5, 2, 4. Quattro, right on. We got some stuff to go through today. We got a bad date story put together by my lovely intern Cheyenne. We're going to talk about a chastity bra. I'm going to go through my other intern Alex's Grammy choices. We'll get to that in a bit. We're going to start off here with this band that is badass. I can't remember if they're from Israel or not, but they're called Carousella. I don't think they're together anymore, but it's just the drummer and a guitar player singer, and she's a chick, and this song's called Star Quality. It's the shit. I think it's cool. We'll follow them with some 7-year bitch. But first off, let's hear about Justin Bieber real quick, because we all love that man.
Is he dead? Did he get killed? That little fucking punk? Unbelievable. Fuck him. Fuck, we're done. Don't you understand? We're done as a nation. This guy, he's gonna get fucking a movie now. He's gonna get a book deal. How I crashed my Lamborghini. We're fucking done. Give me that money, that little fucking prick. Give me that. You know what I'd do with that money? I'd hire somebody to wipe my mother's ass. That's what I would do with that money. Because they got too much, too fast. Don't you understand? These are the role models we have for all these other little fucking shitheads. It's over. It's over. And I'm the fucking band. We're the Titanic. We are sinking. And I'm the band entertaining you people while we are... I'm 53. I'm breaking my fucking ass. 2 jobs. I'm wearing a fucking clip-on tie. And this little prick has the world by the balls on his trousers. What's he got? Problems? Is it a disease? Was he abused when he was... Fuck him. Let him crash. Let him fucking die. And if I saw him crash and die, I would pull over and eat popcorn while I see his fucking brains hanging from the fucking radiator. Fuck Justin Bieber!
Thank you.
from your mother, man.
Yeah, we just banged your mother.
Okay, fuck you, dickhead.
Welcome to another episode of Planet Cacophony. That was 7 Year Bitch with Hip Like Junk, and before that was Curacella. I had my intern Cheyenne pull up this story. She's going through worst date stories ever. This one's called The Gassy Girl. Let's see how this goes. Guy meets girl online. This is their first date. After dinner, she suggested a movie and massages. When it was her turn to give me one, she started rubbing places I didn't expect at all and started turning me on. I really was shocked and couldn't believe she was letting her hands roam all over me, so I turned around and started kissing her, you know, trying to take things to the next level. She then got practically undressed and says, "I have a tampon in and I need to take it out." I told her I'd wait, you know, respectable man. She runs upstairs and takes what seems to be forever. I take the time to myself, more comfortable and stripped only to my boxers, to see her come back in fully dressed and looking surprised. She tells me, "We can't do this. God is watching us and isn't happy. She sits next to me on the couch, and as we talk, I reach over to just pat on her leg and tell her I understand, even though I had no idea what to fucking think. Things seem to be going the way they finally should at this point, until she climbed on top and let loose the loudest, smelliest fart. It was so strong, I could feel the wind all over me. I had to cover my face to keep from gagging on the smell, and to top it off, the condom goes dry. It was all red from her period, which she had told me was gone, and at this point, I couldn't continue anymore, so I stopped to get in the shower. She apologized till she was blue in the face, and I calmed down after the cold shower. Then began to get dressed again. I settled back down on the couch and told myself, it's time for me to leave. I couldn't do anything except shake my head. Embarrassed, she kept asking me to fart on her so she wouldn't feel so bad. I mean, that's the right thing to do, right? So now she's following me around, begging me to fart on her. I couldn't shake anymore, so I had to leave, and I left the house and didn't say anything again to her that night. Alex, you got your mic on right there?
What the hell?
Right on. I mean, you put yourself in that situation. You fart on the girl or what?
No, I wouldn't.
You would not fart on the girl, not to make her feel better? You would just leave? You'd sit there? No worries. We're going to go into another little block here. We got some Mr. Bungle coming up. This is my favorite song by Mr. Bungle. And then we got Green Jelly. You'll recognize that maybe from Dumb and Dumber. And then Red Fang, their new air one called Blood Like Cream. Recently on TV, and here we go.
So you're a freshman, right?
Yeah.
So tell me, man, how's this year's crop of freshman chicks looking?
Well, you're gonna end up in jail sometime really soon, I know that. But
no, man. Yeah. No, man, I'll tell you. Yeah. That's what I love about these high school girls, man. I get older, they stay the same age.
Yes, they do.
Yes, they do.
Motherfuckers out there, it's time to win a chance to fuck bang your daughter's tight virgin cherry ass. Your caller number?
All I can think about is playing. We got girls who eat your pee and poo, and guys who love to fuck your shoe. There's we got mamas with so much glee. Since the skin lights will be a crack. Yeah!
It's on the scene, it's pain.
Oh, this is Dan. You're listening to A Pint of Cacophony. That was fucking Red Fang. Blood Like Cream. Before that was Bear Song by Green Jelly and Girls of Porn by Mr. Bungle off of their first one. All right, the Grammys just happened. I know a lot of people aren't too happy. There's not too many people who are, I'm assuming. But that's okay, because we have our intern, Alex. He's over here. And what we're going to do is kill our guest mics first. And then we're going to get Alex right here, and we're going to take his Grammy readings. So let's do Song of the Year first. And the whole time we're doing this, by the way, if you're watching at SkidRowStudios.com, you can actually see this. My intern, Cheyenne, will be peeling a banana right now, and she will insert this piano into my other intern, Alex's mouth.
Yeah.
And then he will then tell us his Grammy choices.
I guess.
Yes, you guess. And now I want Cheyenne, first things first, I want you to have fun. Look at him. He's your coworker, right? We run a tight ship here. It's a lot of fun sometimes. You know, we have a good time, I'd like to say, right? We have a chemistry. It's only been four episodes.
Yeah.
Three, two, one, four episodes. Right.
Yes.
All right, so let's take this relationship to another level.
Look, they're already laughing.
Nobody's laughing. You shut your mouth, but then get quiet again because you have to open it for the banana.
Yeah.
All right. So we're going to do Song of the Year.
Okay.
Right. The nominations were Royals.
Uh-huh.
Right. That's by Lorde. And then Just Give Me a Reason. That's Pink featuring Nate Ruiz.
Uh-huh.
Locked Out of Heaven. That's Bruno Mars.
Nope.
No. Okay. Oh. And then Roar by Mrs. Katy Perry.
Okay.
All right. So let's get the banana in there. Hold on. Okay. Take it easy. We don't want him eating it.
I'm trying not to put it in my mouth.
Hold on. Open your fucking mouth. Get in there. No, open it. Come on.
I tell friend.
Shameless, man.
Okay.
All right. Yeah, you got it. Hold on. All right. So what's your choice, man? We got Royals, Just Give Me a Reason, Locked Out of Heaven, and Roar. What's it going to be?
I hate all of them, but I'll go with Lorde. I think she won, right?
Yeah, she won, dude.
Yeah.
All right.
I hate all of them.
That's okay. Okay. Don't hate, man. Okay. Don't hate. There's more. All right. What about Best New Artist?
Can you give me the nominee?
Yeah. All right. So we got Macklemore and Ryan Lewis.
Nope.
James Blake.
Who's that?
Kendrick Lamar.
Hell yeah.
Casey Musgraves.
Okay.
And Ed Sheeran.
I'll go with Kendrick.
Kendrick. You like Kendrick Lamar?
I love Kendrick.
So that's what Alex would have chose was Kendrick. All right, hold on. Let's get pop duo. Who gives a shit? Get lucky. Can go fuck itself. Best pop instrumental. I don't really give a fuck. Let's see.
This is getting really
messy. Best pop vocal. Just take the shit and give him a breather. Get it out of his mouth. Okay. Come on. She needs a breath every once in a while. All right, you good?
Yeah, I'm good.
All right, you good? Best dance recording. Yeah, I doubt you have an opinion on that shit.
Mm.
Best dance electronic. Best traditional pop. Oh, here we go. Best rock performance.
Okay.
All right, you got the banana? You're just holding it and eating it now.
I have not bitten it, so.
All right.
I haven't bitten into it.
So, hold on. Cheyenne's got one in her hand. You got one in your own, so we're gonna double fist this. You shouldn't have done that, so let's. You ready?
Yes.
All right, get that shit in your mouth.
Okay.
All right, we got Imagine Dragons with Radioactive.
Mm-mm.
Alabama Shakes, Always All Right.
Oh.
The Stars. Or Out Tonight by David Bowie.
Oh.
Or Cashmere by Led Zeppelin.
Oh, yeah, they did that. They released their live album. And I guess
Jack White, I'm Shaking. My God is the Sun, Queens of Stone Age.
Oh, I would
have
gone Queens.
You don't even have the fucking shit in your mouth. Get it in his mouth.
I'm getting painted over here, man, with the banana.
All right,
okay,
whatever.
I'll follow myself.
Whatever. All right, we're going to move the fuck on.
All right, Queens of Stone Age.
That's what you wanted, Queens of Stone Age. Thank you.
This banana's good.
All right. You're listening to Dan at Skid Row Studios. This is A Pint of Cacophony. Now, we're going to go back into some tunes right here. Let me see what's coming up next. We got another band here called Caravan of Thieves doing a song called Monster. It's a little folky, but hang in there with me. It's a cool one. It's late. And then Chuck Dukowski Sextet doing Open Up the Door. And before that, tonight, when you're strolling home, if you guys are out, just hit on a married woman in front of their husband. Your bruises will rekindle a dead romance.
I saw her sucking on your finger, Daniel. What else has she sucked on?
Daniel. Dan's balls.
Thank you.
time, the whole time you were...
The whole time?
So some words, but I like it anyway.
What the fuck? Where are we? Circus Carnival. We're at a pint of fucking cacophony is where we're at. You cock-juggling boner jockeys. Anyways, my name's Dan. You're listening to Skid Row Studios. I got my buddy here, Matt, sitting in with me. He's a friend of mine.
Oh, hey.
Hey. Oh, shit, that circus music. Can we keep that down a tad?
This is the best dream I've ever had.
This is the worst fucking dream I've ever had and the best at the same time.
You gotta go to a good circus.
Anyways, we're going to talk real quick about the chastity bra. This thing's from fucking Japan. Basically, it's a bra that's locked in, like, the middle, right between the two breasts, and you can't rip it apart. Nobody can break it. It's just fucking impossible. This shit is hooked up to your fucking phone, and according to the product designer, a built-in sensor reads the women's heart rate signal and sends it to a special app via Bluetooth for analysis. The app then calculates the true love rate based on changes in the heart rate over time. This means that there's different sensors on it, and there's different labels, and it says, oh, this dude makes me flirtatious, this guy makes me aroused, this guy makes me bored, this guy makes me depressed. Anyways, when you see this person enough times, it eventually learns yourself, just like your Netflix account does, and it takes it all the way up to love, and when that happens, your bra extremely just bursts open. It doesn't matter where the fuck you are, you can be watching a movie, and it's gonna explode, just like a Mission Impossible tape. Just, you know what I mean.
No, it sounds amazing. But it's confusing, too, because What is a true love measure? To some people, true love is just two fingers.
Yeah, right. No, okay, but that would count on the arousal part, right?
Well, so you got to get her heart rate up.
Yes.
So you
scare the shit out of her, right?
You just chase her through a field for an hour and a half.
Yeah, what you do is, you know, she loves you, right? She gives you her key.
Sure.
You come in with a fucking mask on in the middle of the night. There you go. And then, boom, two fingers. You got a heart rate.
Uh-huh.
You got arousal.
Uh-huh.
Maybe. If you're, I don't know. Maybe not.
No, this is now included in the best dream I've ever had. This with the circus music.
So you're wearing a clown mask is what I'm going with.
It's my favorite mask.
All right, let's get back to some fucking tunes. We're running out of time. That's okay, though. We're not, man. We got plenty of time.
Man.
We're going to go into, Free Range Humans. This song, it's 3 a.m. You got it? 3 a.m. It's foggy, just like it was like 3 days ago in Los Angeles.
What's she wearing?
No. There's no heels.
Oh, okay.
It's just you by yourself and the liquor store. This is Free Range Humans. And then we're going to go into a song I played last week, but this one's the studio one. This is Steve Delameter. He's a fucking fantastic friend of mine. And it's a Pixies song. It's called Hey. And then we're going to follow it with the new Pixies. And I'd like to you guys hit me back on Facebook at A Pint of Cacophony and let me know what you think after what's been a year of three different bass players. We finally got one back, and they're actually putting some shit out. It's called Blue Eyed Hex. Let's check it out. Let's start with Free Range Humans, though. Let's go for it.
Thank you. meet you.
Maybe you'll get lucky at the punk club tonight.
Soul.
Hey, thanks. Thanks, guys. You were listening to A Pint of Cacophony. My name's Dan. Dan Patchinello. You can find us at Facebook at facebook.com/A Pint of Cacophony. We're also on Instagram and Twitter. You can find us there as well. I want to thank Alex for running my board and taking bananas in his mouth. And Cheyenne. Cheyenne, she does everything else. That's it from now on. Cheyenne just does everything else. That's awesome. And I appreciate it. I appreciate the help. You guys are great. You're listening to SkidRowStudios.com. We're here Mondays from 11 p.m. to 12 a.m. You'll find our playlist and our Facebook in the morning if we wake up on time. All right, I'll see you guys next week. And this last song, this one's for my lady. It's called ZZ Top, and it's called I Thank You. Good night, motherfuckers.
Thank you. Thank you for your honesty. Now fuck off and die.